Welcome to the Caribbean Princess cruise ship. Yes, I'm on my annual holiday again, and I wanted to take this opportunity to show you one particular technology that has been rolled out across all of the Princess cruise ships, the Ocean Medallion. This little device is part of what I reckon is one of the biggest home automation systems on the planet. So what actually is the Ocean Medallion then? Well, every passenger on a Princess cruise gets given one of these. It's basically your ID on the ship. You use it to unlock your cabin door, and you can use it to pay for things on board like drinks or souvenirs. But it has so many more features than just that and is jam-packed with technology. Before I came on holiday, I did a bit of investigating, so let's go back in time a few weeks.
So this is an Ocean Medallion that's been donated to me by somebody, and this is a Dremel circular saw. So I'm here in my garage today to see if I can cut this open and have a look inside and see if we can find out what's going on in there. Safety first. So here are the three pieces I've ended up with. We've got this little bit of plastic here which has the sticker on, and I'm gonna just chuck that away because that's nothing important now. Let's start with this piece here. It's got four magnets all around the edge. I'm guessing that helps it attach onto things like your fridge when you get home, or you can use it to align with certain things on the ship. Or stick to accessories, that sort of thing. We've got in here an interesting bit of metal, and this is probably the only electronic component in here. This, I think, must be the Bluetooth aerial. So this little bit here is the brains of the operation. We've got a circular printed circuit board that's surrounded by this copper wiring. Now, this copper wiring is an antenna. In fact, it connects to some terminals that say ANT on the circuit board, and I'm guessing it must be for the NFC because it looks very similar to other RFID and NFC aerials I've seen before. This chip here is the absolute brains of it all. So I'm going to put this under a microscope so as we can see what the lettering is on that. You can see this is the chip that's in question. So it says N52832CIAAE11941FQ. So that's a really catchy name for it. If I move this around, we've got another little chip just here. I'm not sure what that is, but I will look that up as well. And there you go, you can see just there where I said it said ANT on the circuit board. So that's where the NFC antenna is connected. On the other side of this little gadget is a battery. So this is just a flat coin cell. There we go, it's just a regular CR2025 lithium coin cell battery. So nothing too special about it, but it did have those little puncture marks you can see there. That's where it had a connection soldered to it. So now that the battery's been removed, underneath where the battery was on the circuit board are these little debug terminals. That's where the battery was soldered to the to this board.
So as you can see, there's a lot of tech inside an Ocean Medallion. In fact, the medallion itself is covered by a US patent, and the whole wider medallion net solution that this is a part of also has its own Experience Internet of Things platform patent. I started this video by saying that this is a massive home automation system, and it's probably the ultimate home automation system. You see, these medallions are just the tip of the iceberg. Probably shouldn't say iceberg on a cruise ship, actually. But anyway, behind the scenes is a massive network of sensors spread across the whole ship. Some of these are in obvious places, like the information screens scattered around the ship, or the little screens outside each cabin door. But there are many more beacons and sensors hidden all over the place. This means that the ship's automation system knows almost exactly where you are on the ship. Just like when you use presence detection in your home automation system, you might use your own mobile phone paired with a little Bluetooth presence sensor like the ones you can build yourself using ESP Home, which can detect which room you're in based on which sensor has the strongest signal to your phone. And they really make use of presence detection on the ship. Those screens outside the cabins that I mentioned, they know if you are standing in front of them and unlock your door for you. If you are lounging around on a sunbed and can't be asked to move, you can use an app on your phone to order food and drink, and the crew will deliver it to you because they know where you are. If you've got young kids too, then it helps the youth team track you down if there's a problem. Having been on cruises with my children when they were very young, that was a big problem sometimes because the crew would be calling your cabin when you weren't there, or having to find out where you last used your cruise card to buy something in case you were still nearby to that location. So this new system must save them a lot of hassle. So let's go back to the technology inside that medallion again and see how it enables all of this functionality. So this little chip, the NRF52832, is the brains of the whole operation. It's made by a company called Nordic Semiconductors, and their website is nordicsemis.com. Yes, I typed Nordic Semis into my browser. Just be careful what you click on, okay? It has a built-in Bluetooth low energy radio and an NFC radio. It also supports Bluetooth mesh, but I don't think that particular feature is in use in the medallion. So the NFC radio is clearly used for those tap-to-pay features like a contactless credit or debit card works, except you don't even have to tap to pay. The system just tells the staff it's you and they confirm it using your security photo. But the Bluetooth radio is going to be the component that enables the location tracking. That's why it has a battery, because that Bluetooth radio needs power to be able to send out its unique ID to be picked up by the Bluetooth location sensors. In theory, this chip could also support audio, so if there was a microphone built into it, then the medallion could respond to voice commands. Don't worry though, I couldn't find any signs of a microphone on the circuit board, so it's not listening to you yet. So apart from this being quite a cool gadget, I also need to talk about sustainability. So every passenger on a Princess cruise gets given one of these medallions. They also get given a lanyard to keep it in, or you can buy a wrist strap or many other accessories. I went for a wristband, and this is actually their sustainably produced one. It's made from 100% recycled ocean plastic, which is great if you look at this in isolation. These medallions are single use because firstly, they are sealed and contain the battery that runs out. And secondly, they engrave your name and cruise number into it. According to the Princess website, 1.7 million passengers sail with them every year. Each medallion weighs about 10 grams. That works out at 17 metric tons of e-waste from these medallions every year. Now, I know some people keep them as a souvenir and stick them on their fridge, but I reckon most of them end up going to landfill, and new ones need to be made too. Princess, if you see this video, then please consider making these reusable. The Apple AirTag is roughly the same size, has a replaceable battery, and is still reasonably watertight. Change the design, stop soldering the battery in, make the battery easy to replace, put the passenger information on a sticker instead of engraving them. Collect them back when passengers disembark the ship, and you've stopped a huge amount of waste. Anyway, I hope you found this little overview of the Ocean Medallion technology interesting. A big thank you to my channel members for supporting my channel. That's these people listed here. If you'd like to become a channel member too and get early access to my videos, then check out the link in the description. Don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for free to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.